Thank you, Madam Speaker. Look, I rise to read back to the House the comments quietly slipped in, the stink bomb that was quietly delivered by Minister Barnett this morning in question time, when he revealed that he has accepted the recommendations of the Marine Farming Review Panel and has approved an application by Petuna to set up a massive fish farm off Betsy Island in Storm Bay. This was a sham process, Madam Speaker. It's a disgrace. And I will just take the House through the process, the corrupted process that has been used to date. What happened was this approval was made, a recommendation was made by the Marine Farming Review Panel on the 30th of November. Approved by the minister on the 2nd of April, so there was a 4 month gap there. In the process of approval for the Marine Farming Review Panel, there were hundreds of people who made submissions. There were public hearings that went for days in Hobart, and not a single one of the submissions that were made or the public statements that were made in the hearings process were taken account of at all in the process of the panel making its deliberation. And we can be quite confident about that because we've had a look at the information that was provided to the panel by the Marine Farming Branch, which is the branch of the department that provided information to the panel. On the submissions. They made an assessment about what information the panel should take account of and what it shouldn't. And what we have is, on almost every occasion, the recommendation to the panel was that the representation that had been made or the submission that had been received didn't create any need for modification of the draft amendment. And I want to just read in the comments that were made by Christine Coconow on behalf of the Derwent Estuary Program, which was a bombshell in the hearing process, Madam Speaker, because the issues that were raised by the Derwent Estuary Programs, their severe concern about the impact on the nutrient load on the Derwent Estuary, on the Derwent River, with a proposed 40,000 tonnes of fish excrement each year going into the into Storm Bay and up into the Derwent River, their comments make it really clear that there is no environmental baseline, that there is no accounting for the impact on the whole system from the Storm Bay proposals. Christine Coconow, on behalf of the Derwent Estuary Program, raised issues about water quality, substrate and fauna, marine vegetation, threatened species, introduced marine pests, climate change, environmental management, recreational fishing, land use and development, marine farm planning practice, holistic impact assessment, none of which were considered relevant by the department, the Marine Farming Branch, for the panel to take any account of in their assessment of the application. So this is a rubber stamping committee. There were only five of the nine panel members present when the decision was made for the Petuna Storm Bay approval. The panel was meant to have a person with expertise in biosecurity. That person was not there. A person with expertise in fish health, a person with expertise in environmental management, a person nominated by the chairperson of the Tasmanian Planning Commission, and a person with boating, recreational and navigational issues. None of those people were on the panel, Madam Speaker, when the recommendation was made by the panel for that particular application for Storm Bay to go ahead. It's a disgrace. It's an outrage. It's a total abuse of a process which the government pretends to be world's best practice. It's anything but. So what we know is that the threatened screw shell is found in the vicinity of the lease in the survey area. There will be, in all likelihood, an investigation of the EPBC impact of that Storm Bay Fish Farm on that particular animal. The EPA still has its processes to go through. But what is incredibly clear is that there was absolutely nothing that this government was prepared to listen to in terms of science or community comments, the impact on other industries and the impact on the marine environment about this fish farm expansion going ahead. This is all about opening the door to the industry for access to public waterways, endangering the impact on marine environment and on people's lives and people's businesses. And there is nothing that the Liberal Party is doing to protect anything except the interests of those three big fish farm companies. It's a shame. People do understand that this government is not standing up for them or the marine environment. It's only the Greens who are speaking out about this. Labor is lockstep on this position. It's a false idea to imagine that it will benefit anyone other than the industry and its own private profit-making activities.
House stands adjourned.